you definitely noticed that the amount of test code we wrote so far is quite significant. And having all this test code means that in practice, you're not going to only have large production code bases, but also large test code bases. And in the same way that you put lots of effort to make sure that your production code is maintainable, you have to do the same thing for the test code. After all, tests are now code and you will have to maintain them. And that is the focus of this week. We will study how to better write test code and how to better maintain our test suites. As we have been discussing, in terms of structure, automated tests are all very similar. Let's revisit it. Do you remember the AAA? Arrange, act, and assert? Let's take as an example a test we wrote at the beginning of the course. This test code represents the case where years can be centurial, but not necessarily leap years. We always have the arrange part, which is where we have the inputs we want to provide to the program in that specific test case. Then we act. In this case, we invoke the method that contains the behavior we want to test. And finally, we then assert. We make sure that the program behaves as expected for that given input. In production code, we often use the term code smells to refer to indications or symptoms that usually point to a deeper problem in the system. Examples of well-known code smells are long methods or long classes, and lots of research have already shown that code smells can definitely hinder the comprehensibility and the maintainability of software systems. So we should try to avoid code smells as much as possible. If we apply the same idea for test code, we have test smells. A test has an arrange, act, and assert part. And each of these parts have their own challenges. And therefore, lots of things can go wrong or smell in any of them. Can you think about possible smells for test code? You have been writing lots of test code in this course. Can you think of possible implementation decisions you took that made your test suite less readable or hard to maintain? Something that you didn't like in the arrange part of the test or in the assert part of the test? Pause this video and write your thoughts in a piece of paper. And believe it or not, research also shows that test smells do happen a lot in real life and can negatively affect us. For example, in this paper, Bavota and his co-authors show that test smells are actually widely spread and that they do have a strong negative impact on code comprehensibility. This means that smelly tests are harder for you as a developer to understand and comprehend. In another study, Spadini and his co-authors show that tests that are affected by smells are more prone to change and more prone to defects than tests that are not affected by smells or are good tests. So throughout this week, we will basically study this book, XUnit Test Patterns, written by Gerard Mezahos. This book is all about best practices on how to write good test code and all about possible test smells that we may face and how to remove them. Okay, so fasten your seatbelts.